Here's another polynomial division problem. What we're going to do here is I'm going to do it both ways, long division and then synthetic division, so you guys get used to seeing both ways. Now this one is special because it's missing terms. It's missing an x squared term. It's missing an x term. You see how it goes straight to x to the third to the constant? It's missing terms. So we got to put those dudes in. So we're going to go x to the third plus 0x squared plus 0x minus 1. So these are the missing terms with the zeros. Now I'm dividing by x minus 1. Let's get busy. So this guy divided by x, that would be doing this in our head. X to the third divided by x to the 1. So you subtract the exponents, you get x to the second power. Distribute it to those two. Distribute this guy to those two terms. We're going to get x to the third minus 1x squared. And then to subtract this, I change the signs, then add them. These ones add to zero, so I can cross those out. And then for this one, I get 1x squared. I bring down a 0x, so I have plus 0x. And now I go x squared divided by x. And then I get a 1x. X squared divided by x. That's how I got 1x. Notice how I like to put the like terms on top of each other. That's just an organizational thing. You don't have to do that, but I like to do it because it kind of helps out in some parts. So we got 1x times x minus 1. We get x squared. Then we have a minus 1x. Then to subtract this, I change the signs of every single term, and then I add them together. So this adds to 0, so I can cross that out. I get 1x, and then I bring down this negative 1. I have x minus 1 and x minus 1, so since those are the same, you would get 1. You go x minus 1. Then you subtract it, you get remainder of 0. So this is our answer right there. So this is what it would look like if we did synthetic division. All right. So we got x to the third power. And I got to write this out because I know there's missing terms. And I don't want to miss any of them. So I got my two missing terms in there. Now I can see all my coefficients. I have a 1, then a 0, then a 0, then a negative 1. So I write those out. 1, 0, 0, negative 1. I get my little birdhouse thing. I don't know, whatever you want to call that, ledge. And now I look at the x minus 1 and I go, okay, if this is a factor, if x minus 1 is a factor, what is the 0 for that guy? And you would say 1. So then we draw that line right there. I like to draw this little pocket. You don't have to. I bring down the 1 as my first order of duty here. 1 times 1, we get 1. Then you have 0 plus 1, you get 1. 1 times 1 again, so you put 1 right there, and then you got 0 plus 1. So you get 1 again. 1 times 1. Man, look at all these 1s.
Uno.
All right, now we've got a remainder of 0 at the end. This looks exactly like our answer over here. See, check it out. We had our remainder, then constant, x term, x squared term. It always goes like that. So we have no remainder, but we have a constant term. Then we have our x term, and then we have the x squared term. You don't have to write ones when those are coefficients, but I'm writing them anyways so you guys can see it. All right, there you go. Long division versus synthetic division.